So, stepped inside the woods here on where the trail crosses in Daleville. Probably about something like 0.6 miles from the hotel. It's a little bit after 11. I left about 10:30. Checkout was at 11. And I got a dentist appointment today, which it's kind of crazy. So yesterday I walked all the way 2.4 miles from the hotel to the dentist's office and sent them a text, because that's what they do with all the COVID stuff going on. And they send me a text back and say, which branch are you at? And I tell them, and they're like, yeah, we got you scheduled in Roanoke. And I'm like, that would have been great to know beforehand. But anyway, yeah. So they sent me a text later and said, we got you Friday at 9:30. So today's Thursday. So I'm like, well, I guess I'm getting another hotel or another night. And I walked back all the way back, 5 miles, or close to it. But had to run by the store about halfway there anyway. So anyway, I sitting at the hotel last night, and they call me and they say, hey, we got something to open Thursday for 1:30. I'm like, I'll take it. So checkout was at 11. I left about 10, I guess about 10:35, something like that. Come back to the trail, which is this side of the hotel, which further up is the dentist. And yeah, instead of standing on the side of the road out in the heat or in a parking lot, stepped up the AT a little bit and hung my hammock up. So this is what we're doing for right now. Yeah. Hopefully they can get this fixed. We'll see how I feel afterwards. I mean, I don't think I'll feel groggy, but if I do, then I'll just I'll stay up here at the Hojo. I think the ratings are horrible, but yeah, it's $50 a night, and it's right by the trail, so don't need to be spending money though. So hopefully I'll feel fine and keep on trekking north to either the first or second shelter, which I will have already walked 5 miles before I even hit the trail. But I know, wah, wah, wah. Sound like a baby. Anyway, yeah. Well, guess I'll keep y'all updated. Peace. Yo. So, went and saw the dentist today about 1:30. I got my tooth fixed. Dentist had told me, said that the nerve's dead, and I may lose the tooth. The two options are implant or root canal. But anyway, he said he could have done one today, but he likes to, you know, do it over two visits because it's a lot to do, or I don't know exactly. But anyway, he said what he could do was patch it and put it back together as good as he could, and I just try to be careful with it, and maybe it'll last me to the end of the trail until I can go back to see my dentist. So that's what he did. He did an outstanding job. And anyway, I went to go pay my bill, and the lady's explaining to me the charges, and it came to like $384. And she said, yeah, and the doctor said to just waive the fee. I know what that was. That was a good Lord. So anyway, yeah. Got me some antibiotics. It took a while to get that filled. Waited out a rainstorm at the CVS. By the time I got back here, or back to the trailhead, which is right over there, it was right at 5. And I just said, you know what? I'm just getting one more night at the hotel. I didn't really feel like hiking like crazy for almost dark in the mud and going up a mountain, because it's steep. By the guide, and just getting up, trying to get camp set up in the dark, and so one more night. So here I sit at the Super 8 in Daleville for my fourth night in Daleville. It's a vacation spot. But anyway, yeah, I'm gonna get up bright and early, try to knock out some miles. So we will see you then. Peace. Good morning. So I've been back on the trail for a little over 3 miles, getting ready to hike through this field here. be awesome. Anyway, it's been 4 days in Daleville, but back on the trail and it feels good. Hopefully, the old tooth will hang in there, literally, and get back to getting some miles done. Yeah. So anyway, everything's good today. Got some storms coming in, but that's summertime. Anyway, keep y'all updated. Peace. Morning from Boblet Gap Shelter. Stayed here last night, right there, hanging between two of them trees back there. Yeah, the ones that's right behind me. Anyway, did 18 miles yesterday. Was in like the worst electrical storm I've probably been in outside. It was crazy. I was praying like crazy. Man, it was terrifying. I ain't gonna lie. I ain't gonna try to be a man and be like, yeah, it wasn't nothing. No, that scared the crap out of me. I was, there's like a brick wall, like a huge brick wall. I think it holds up the dirt that the Blue Ridge Parkway road is on. And I was way down that brick wall and hunkered down. And you could hear the lightning just going from a far off, boom, 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 boom. It just kept getting louder and louder. It's like it was in a straight line and I was right in the path. And man, it was crazy. It was popping all around. It popped up on the road somewhere above me. Yeah. That was a wake-up call. Tell you what, next time I have 7 miles to hike and I see there's a storm coming, I ain't moving. I'll stay in the shelter. Cook dinner, hang out, take a nap. But I ain't getting back out in that mess again. At least if I'm watching, it may, you know, one may creep up on me. But, yeah, I can always hike at night. But, anyway, besides that, got about close to 15 today or 18. If I do the 18, I got to climb, yeah, like 3,000 feet or something. So, maybe a 15-mile day. I'd like to catch up back with Defy, but that dentist thing, man, that held me back a day, but at least my tooth is fixed, so, yeah. They say there's a chance of showers today, but right now it's beautiful. So, it's 7:59, better get my lazy tail on the trail. So, yeah, peace. Yo. Guess what? It's like 8:47 and it's already blazing hot. So, yesterday I only hiked about 10 miles and saw a sign for milkshakes and cheeseburgers. And apparently these people know my weaknesses. So, I went to Middle Creek Campground. It's awesome. Didn't actually have a campsite, but they let you set up there for $10. You get a shower. Yeah. And they had good food. So, I was going to do more yesterday, but to be honest, it was one of those days. It was hot. The humidity was so high. I don't know. I did 18 and a half before, so. I just said, you know what? What the heck? 10-mile day. So, today I'm trying for 21. I'm not even going to try to be optimistic and think I can do it.
but I'm gonna try. May end up cutting it short, but trying to make some miles up, so we'll see what the heat is like. It's supposed to be 90 degrees a day, so, and I got a lot of climbing. I've already climbed one little mountain, but I gotta climb one three times the size, so, and a lot of little ups and downs from there, so we'll see. Yeah, but you know, I'll keep you updated. Peace. Morning. Stayed at Thunder Hill Shelter last night. Only did about 14 and a half miles yesterday, but it was up like 3,500 feet and it was hot. I was wanting to do 21. Now we got to the top of the mountain and that was it. That's all she wrote. So anyway, I got about 14, I think it's about 14 and a half maybe. I don't know, I have to check, but I'm trying to make it to Stanimals Hostel in Glasgow, Virginia. Glasgow, Glasgow. Kim Basinger. I don't know, whatever you call it. But anyway, didn't rain last night, so life is good. Yeah, you know, this time of year, it just doesn't rain. It's like, you're not getting that rain without lightning and crazy weather. But yeah, so it was very peaceful last night. Had 8 people at the shelter last night. Of course, you know, everybody's in their tents. Some of them weren't thru-hikers, but pretty cool. Glad to see things getting a little bit back to normal. Yep, that's about it. So, I'm gonna get to trucking. Talk with you in a bit. Yes. Here. So today is one of those days where you walk a tenth of a mile and you sit down. And you walk a tenth of a mile and you sit down. This is really tough today. It's hot. It's going to get hotter. Struggling today. Probably the worst I've struggled so far. Guess that's what happens when you get a little age on you. I hear it gets better. Yeah. Well, anyway, we'll get there eventually. I'm only doing, I guess, 10 miles to Punch Bowl Shelter. They say the flies are bad there, but I'm so tired, I don't care. Just gonna hang out with the flies, I guess. Be like the Charlie Brown kid again. Just been like that, like at every shelter. They're swarming. They're all out on the trail. You get that little gnat that rides right here all day long. You swat him away, and a replacement comes, and he just hangs out right here. Mosquitoes, all kinds of stuff. But kind of comes along with being out in the woods in June. So, yeah. Anyway, if I don't pass out, I'll keep y'all updated. And even if I do, when I wake up, I'll keep you updated.
Peace. Look at that.